Hey there, eggheads. Juan Carlos Bagnell here, continuing our celebration of gaming all month long here in June 2020. Right about now is usually when we'd be getting ready to cover E3, but with that not happening this year, instead, it's a good time to take a look at the gear we actually use to play the games we love. This time around, we're talking about PC gaming peripherals, specifically things like keyboards, mice, and headsets. Now, some of you out there might already consider yourselves experts in this subject, and that's great, but we see a lot of comments on our videos and on Newegg.com from people who are new to this hobby and who are looking to have some important gaming peripheral terms explained to them. With that in mind, let's cover some of the terms you're going to encounter when you're shopping for PC gaming peripherals. If you think we miss any terms or if you have some advice of your own, help out your fellow gamers in the comments down below. First up, mechanical keyboard. When you hear that phrase, know that it's referring to what happens when you actually press down on one of the keys of your keyboard. Mechanical keyboards have a physical mechanism under the keycap that engages when you press down. Now, back in the early days of computing, mechanical keyboards were the standard. But over time, alternatives like membrane keyboards became more popular for general use. Your standard office keyboard is probably a membrane board, which doesn't rely on the same kind of physical switch under the keycaps. Instead, there's a conductive circuit under the caps that triggers the electronic signals when the keys are pressed. Now, when it comes to PC gaming, mechanical keyboards have become the generally preferred option because of the feedback they give, both in terms of a tactile click and the sound they make. The idea being that the more feedback you're getting from your board, the less likely you are to miss keystrokes in the heat of gaming action. Granted, if you're playing something slow-paced like Civilization, the need for a mechanical keyboard is debatable at best, but many PC gamers just prefer the sound and feel of mechanical switches, in contrast to the sometimes smushy feeling of membrane keyboards. Mechanical keyboards usually do cost a bit more than membrane options, but they often also come with other gamer-friendly features like RGB lighting. And there's also a hybrid model of gaming keyboards that's come out in recent years called mem-chanical, which aims to offer more of the sound and feel of a mechanical keyboard combined with some of the advantages a membrane board offers, like lower costs. In the world of mechanical keyboards, there are a few more terms worth defining. A clicky switch is one that's designed to give you especially noticeable auditory feedback. A tactile switch is one in which you'll feel a notable bump as you depress the keycap, letting you know the press has been registered. While a linear switch is one that's designed to be pressed all the way down without that same tactile bump. There are also whole families and flavors of mechanical switch types like Cherry MX and Gateron that all have their own passionate defenders. But we have other topics to cover in this video, so just head on over to our mechanical keyboards if you want to learn more. When checking out gaming keyboards, you'll also hear a lot about anti-ghosting and N-key rollover, which both basically refer to the ability of your keyboard to register multiple keystrokes at once. If you think about normal typing, there aren't many scenarios where you would need to press more than three keys at a time, but when you're playing games, you might need more than that. If you need to move forward and run and jump and switch weapons and launch a grenade all at the same time, assuming you have enough fingers for all of that, then you'll want a keyboard with N key rollover, since that lets you know it can handle all of the key presses simultaneously. Next up, macros. This often pops up in referring to programmable gaming keys on a keyboard or a mouse. A macro is a complicated sequence or combination of button presses that you have to do a lot that you can combine and assign to a single button press. You see these a lot in MMOs and other keyboard-intensive games, but if you have a keyboard or mouse that supports macros and offers you programmable buttons, the limit is really just your imagination. With the right keyboard and software support, you can open up a chat window and type, "Hey man, great game, thanks for playing. It was super fun," all with the touch of a single key. Just one idea off the top of my brain, wouldn't that be wholesome? One last thing to know when talking about gaming keyboards, a USB pass-through port is a USB port usually found on the back edge of the keyboard near the cable that can provide power or data, just like a normal port on your PC. Using one of these usually means the USB cable coming out of your keyboard will split at the end and will require you to plug in two ports on your actual system. But the advantage is you get a USB port that's much more easily accessible right on top of your desk. All right, let's talk gaming mice. When you look at gaming mice, you'll also hear about switches like you do with keyboards. In the case of mice switches, we're referring to the mechanism that actually clicks when you press the button down on the mouse. There are a few popular brand names when it comes to mouse switches, like Omron, for example. And you'll usually hear that they're rated for something like 50 million clicks. That means that the switch is designed to last a long, long time. Probably longer than the average gamer would ever use a mouse. The other major bit of tech you'll hear about with gaming mice is the sensor, and that refers to the way that the mouse tracks movement across your desk surface or mouse pad. Mouse sensors are typically rated in DPI, which stands for dots per inch, with higher ratings indicating a sensor is capable of greater sensitivity. Like a lot of things with gaming peripherals, the extreme measurements you'll see in some products are likely only going to be relevant to extreme gamers. It's unlikely that an average PC gamer needs a mouse with a sensor capable of 18,000 DPI, for example, but if you're a professional esports sniper, then you might care about the more extreme DPI sensitivity settings available. Most modern mice have either optical or laser sensors, which refers to the kind of light they emit from the bottom to track movement across the surface. Laser mice can have a bad reputation among gamers because they can have problems with acceleration when moving rapidly. But if you get a mouse with a high enough polling rate, which refers to how often the mouse registers its position as you move it, then acceleration shouldn't be too much of a problem. Laser mice can perform better on certain surfaces, like glass. But for most people, most of the time, you're probably gonna want an optical mouse for PC gaming. One last thing we'll say about mice, and this can apply to keyboards or gaming headsets too. A braided cable refers to the thicker, reinforced type of cable that you can often find on higher end peripherals. This is in contrast to a regular plastic cable, the kind of thing you probably have on your phone charger. A braided cable is sturdier and can last longer under wear and tear, though they don't provide quite the same flexibility to twisting in extreme angles as non-braided cables can. All right, last but not least, let's move on to one of my favorite topics, gaming headsets. Now, many PC gaming headsets you can get will also work with consoles, or really any device that has a headphone jack, if that's the connection they use. But there are also many that are run through USB, not a 3.5 millimeter jack, and those tend to be PC only. Only a few have limited support for consoles like the PlayStation 4. Headsets come in a few different styles, including over-ear, that's circum-aural, versus on-ear, that's supra-aural. Many gaming headsets are over-ear, which can be better for long-term comfort and can sound better and more realistic because of the larger ear cups, creating a more natural sound environment. On-ear headsets can be cheaper and lighter, and so those can also be a bit more portable. Depending on the headband type, an on-ear might also help you block noise in your environment if that's a concern by being a bit more clampy to the side of your head, but that might also affect long-term comfort. Another term you'll see a lot with gaming headsets, virtual surround sound. Now, most people know what actual surround sound is, whether it's a 5.1 setup with 5 speakers and 1 subwoofer, or 7.1 that ups it to 7 speakers. There are some headsets that have actual, true surround sound with multiple distinct drivers built into the ear cups of the headset, mapped to an accurate surround sound configuration, but these tend to be expensive. Virtual surround sound is cheaper to include in a headset than actual surround sound, and it can actually have some other advantages too. Because it's based on algorithms that distort and delay sound waves so that they seem to be coming from further away or from specific angles, many virtual surround sound headsets are actually pretty customizable, with a variety of settings that can be tweaked to give you the best experience for different games or if you're just watching a movie. a lot of audio purists will scoff at virtual surround sound as not being real. But as a counter argument, nothing else in the games you're playing is actually real either, right? You're watching a virtual spaceship fly around in virtual space and listening to sound in relation to your virtual avatar. Maybe it's okay that your surround sound is virtual too. Not to mention that some of these headsets can provide a tactical advantage too, with this virtual stereo landscape harder positioning virtual sound effects in space around you. Of course, there's a lot more we could cover about gaming, keyboards, mice, and headsets, but we're gonna kick it over to you in the comments. Chime in with your best advice for new PC gamers, and let us know what your favorite gaming peripherals are. And you can visit the links right below this video to head over to Newegg and check out the keyboards, mice, and headsets that are on sale right now. As always, thanks so much for watching, for sharing these videos, and subscribing to the channel. For Newegg Studios, I'm Juan Carlos Bagnell, and I'll catch y'all on the next video.